Takashi Miike's Audition is a much discussed and scolded movie, which is considered by many to be a disturbing movie because of the torture scene at the end. Even though it is only a 10-minute ordeal, where the remaining 105 minutes of the movie are more of a sad romantic drama. Through this movie, Miike became known in the movie world, although it was already his 35th movie. He also shot these 35 films in only 9 years, which is impressive in its own way. What many people don't know is that the movie is based on a book. The book was written by Ryo Murakami and was published in 1997, 2 years before the movie was released. Miike stays true to the main plot of the book and describes how the two main characters get to know each other up until the disturbing climax. Of course, as it's always the case, there are minor and major differences from the book, such as the fact that Aoyama selects 31 candidates for the audition in the book, but there are only 30 in the movie, or that Miike repeatedly introduces small interludes, such as Asami sitting motionless on the floor in her apartment, just waiting for the call from Aoyama, and all this with a threatening undertone, to perhaps prepare the viewer for the fact that something is not right here. However, in Murakami's book, such interludes of Asami's current life are not described before the climax, but only at the end when Aoyama is struck by her and it turns out that she is a serial killer who kills her male victims as soon as it turns out that they are just as bad and corrupt as her abusive stepfather. In this video, I present you 8 differences between Murakami's book and Miike's movie. So stay cool, get out your wire saw and acupuncture needles, but above all, hide your dogs, because the first point is nothing for dog and animal lovers. Number 1. The death of Aoyama's dog. In the movie, we only see the dog's corpse lying on the floor as Asami gets ready to work on Aoyama. The head is turned backwards, suggesting that Asami broke his neck. In the book, however, this is not the case. Here, the dog suffers the terrible fate that all of Asami's male victims must suffer. She has also drugged him like Aoyama, and even before she turns her attention to the drugged Aoyama, she lays the body of the little fur nose on the coffee table directly in front of him and cuts off both of his hind legs with a wire saw, causing him to die afterwards. As a little bonus to the cute little fur nose, who is a beagle in both mediums, the dog's name in the English language book is Gangstar. In the movie with Japanese original audio, it is Gangu, and in the German dubbed version, they call him Bastard. Unfortunately, I don't have the original Japanese book or the English sub version of the movie for final comparison, so if anyone knows it, please leave a comment and let us know. The next point is a bit more pleasant, even if the death of a loved one is nothing to be happy about. Number 2. Aoyama's goals after the death of his wife. In the book, it is described that after the death of his wife, Aoyama has set 2 goals in his life. The first goal is to spend more time with his son Shige. This is what he sticks to and does from then on, and what he also considers successful. The second goal is to bring a famous and legendary East German pipe organist to Japan and play a concert. He also successfully completes this goal, which brings the subject of second wife into play. Anyway, this whole objective is not described and dealt with in the movie. He does spend time with his son, for example at the beginning when they are fishing, but the second goal from the book with a German musician does not appear in the movie at all. Number 3. The course of the story. Even though it seems like this is only a small difference, but the impact on the whole story is huge. Because the book really only follows Aoyama and it also tells the story in a very linear fashion, from the death of his wife, to his life goals, then from the audition to their first dates and sharing personal experiences, and of course from their first night together to the torture, including Asami's backstory and the abrupt ending. So it's a little love drama, just with a very disturbing ending. The movie follows the storyline as well, but Miike throws scenes in between of Asami alone in her apartment, with a very threatening undertone, or even before it comes to the torture of Aoyama, there are some flashbacks and additional scenes. This has additional dialogue between Asami and Aoyama from a restaurant scene that we haven't seen before, or scenes of Asami's abuse when she was a child. What Miike also presents, which is not in the book at all, is how she then cuts off her stepfather's head, as well as how she keeps the record company producer in a bag in her apartment like an animal and feeds him with her own vomit. So it's also a little love drama, but with horror elements in between and of course with a disturbing ending. The aforementioned record company producer brings us to point number 4. Number 4. A barmaid in Ginza and a record company producer. In the movie, when Asami is asked at the audition if she has any references, she says a record company producer named Shibata. Later, when Aoyama's friend is researching him, he finds out that he has been missing for a year, and as we as viewers are later able to discover, is that Asami is holding him captive at her home as a kind of pet, with his feet cut off, the tongue and one ear missing, and also 3 fingers are missing. In the book, Asami tells at the audition that she has a mentor at a record company, also named Shibata, and when Aoyama's friend researches him, he finds out that he died a year and a half ago due to a heart attack because someone tried to cut off both of his feet. Related to this point, in the movie Asami tells at the audition that she often works in a bar in Ginza and that this bar belongs to a woman. Later, after Asami's disappearance, when Aoyama goes to this bar, he is told by a neighbor that the bar is closed and that the barmaid was killed and dismembered. And when they put the body parts together, the police had an extra tongue, an extra ear and 3 fingers too many. This is where the connection between the record company producer and the barmaid is made in the movie. Asami killed the barmaid and mutilated Shibata because he hurt her as much as her stepfather. In the book, she also tells at the audition that she helps out in a bar, but that's about it and there's nothing else about it in the book. Number 5. Confessions. How does Asami went so crazy and then decides to kill Aoyama according to her killing motive? In the book, Aoyama tells Asami during a date, which is before their first night together, that he had a wife but she died 7 years ago. Even though she gets upset at first and leaves the date, the two do get closer again. Because here she says on her first night together that he must love her and her alone. He agrees to this. After the first night, he finds a note that says, "No forgiveness for lies." Since he doesn't know exactly what happened the night before because Asami drugged him, he can't remember if he might have told her about his son Shige. In the movie, he also accepts to love her and no one else, but he never told her about his dead wife and he never told her about his son. Later, however, in Aoyama's house, we see a camera shot of Asami's first person perspective that she discovers the picture of his wife in his house. Later during the torture, she also mentions his son, to which Aoyama naturally reacts and she says to him, "So you don't just love me?" In both the book and the movie, it is also clear that she knows that the audition was just a fake. Although it is never made clear since when she knows this and whether it is really the main reason for what she is doing at the end, but by doing so, she definitely has proof that Aoyama is just as bad as her stepfather was, and thus plans his fate. And to seal his fate, of course the right work clothes are needed, which brings us to the next point. Number 6. Asami's work clothes. Already iconic and recognizable from the movie, she wears black rubber gloves, black boots, as well as an apron which is also known from other serial killers from film and TV. Under the apron she wears a white t-shirt as well as a light colored skirt. In the book, on the other hand, everything is kept very simple. Here she wears surgical rubber gloves, a black sweater, as well as jeans and sneakers. For one of the working tools, I'm not an expert on this and don't know if there's a difference, but in the movie she uses piano wire, but in the book she uses a wire saw with circles on each end. Why do I mention this? Probably just as a smooth transition to the next point, which is the scene that made this movie so infamous. Number 7. The torture. Here the movie takes some liberties. The acupuncture needles only exist in the movie and not in the book. In the book it also happens that Aoyama is able to partially move again, but just for a bit, and after a little diversion with the remote from the music system and a short circuit that caused it to go dark, he is able to move away from Asami. He only makes it to the stairs leading to the second floor. There Asami is able to overwhelm him again. In the movie, however, this is not the case and Aoyama remains on the floor the entire time, while Asami works on him with the acupuncture needles and then subsequently cuts off his left foot with the piano wire. In the book, Asami cuts off his left foot as well, but there she does it on the stairs and with a wire saw. Book Aoyama also manages to kick Asami off the stairs with his left stump, where Asami hits her head and breaks her right arm, which is then followed by the last point. Number 8. The end. When it comes to the ending, both book and movie end equally abrupt, but again it is different in both mediums. In the movie, Shige comes home to find his father tortured and lying on the floor. Asami then sneaks up behind him with Mace and chases him through the house. During this chase, Asami is kicked down the stairs from the second floor by Shige and she comes down hot at the bottom. As a result, you can see that her neck is broken and that she can't move anymore. With her head twisted, looking towards Aoyama, she still speaks briefly to him, while Shige calls the police. In the book, Shige also arrives home to find his father mutilated, but lying on the stairs, and again, Asami sneaks up with Mace and a short chase begins. Shige is able to dodge her and throws a glass yogurt container in her face, breaking her nose. He runs towards the drink cabinet, where he pulls out a combat knife with a 30 cm long blade. As we learned earlier in the book, his mother hid it there after Aoyama brought it back from a trip. With this knife, he stabs her in the neck and she dies. Aoyama then asks Shige what she was saying all the time during this hunt, and he answers, "Liar, liar," just that one word over and over. To which Shige asks, "What was this all about?" Aoyama replies that he really doesn't know. Which brings the book to its abrupt end. These were 8 differences and a few between the movie audition and its book. Overall, it is a movie adaptation that remains faithful to its source material, but that every now and then tries to play a surreal event for the viewer. Because what if it was all just Aoyama's dream? If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and a comment and subscribe for more. Until next time, have an awesome day.